Hi, wrestling fans. Welcome to Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, television's most exciting hour. And we have a lot in store this hour. We're going to be bringing you an update on the Great American Bash 86. The bash is definitely on the way. We'll be hearing from NWA President Bob Geigel concerning the Great American Bash. In other news, we have new six-man World Tag Team Champions, the Road Warriors, Dusty Rhodes, having defeated Ivan and Nikita Koloff and Baron Von Raschke. And on a sad note, Ricky Morton was severely injured as he had his nose badly broken at the hands of Nature Boy Ric Flair. Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson will be talking with Rick. We'll be showing you that, and we'll be talking also by tape with the World Heavyweight Champion Nature Boy Ric Flair. All of that and more upcoming during this hour. And fans, right here, we have with us Boogeyman Jimmy Valiant, the Raging Bull, and hey, Boogie.
Here comes the judge, here comes the judge, here comes the judge. I'm the judge, and this is a jury. Pistol Pez Wadley, Paul Jones, we send you to the chair. I'm talking about the lifted chair. Bobby, you know what happens when they prepare a guy for the chair?
Save him, that's right.
You're right, brother, and it's all gonna happen before the bash.
You know, when he talks about people, Daddy, he's talking about people getting bald. And bald people are going to be running all around the bash because nobody does the bash better than the Bull. And Waylon Jennings, Daddy, is going to bash all over just like the Bull is. Ronnie Garvin, I know you got a lot in mind, too.
Talking about bash, I'm looking for Tully Blanchard, you know, the national champion going around the country doing a lot of bad things, you know. Well, I'm going to tell you, nobody stretches me out of that ring without paying for it. And I'm going to tell you, Tully Blanchard, you got an open contract, I got a contract, and if you're mad enough, you're that tough, you put your name on that dotted line. Tape fist, 3 minute rounds, 10 rounds of 3 minutes, tape fist match anywhere.
All right, fans, let's go to the ring. We're ready for action. There by gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, preceded into the ring by Precious. And of course, his opponent in the other corner, Todd Champion, a great athlete. Of course, you got to remember that Todd is really new in the wrestling profession. They're looking for a lot of big things out of this young man, but he is starting at the very bottom, Bob. He did come on here in his first national television match and won that match. He's got a lot of fire. But it's going to be a lot tougher for him against the gorgeous one in this match. No doubt, John. A different caliber competition in Jimmy Garvin. But as you say, he's a great athlete, a tremendous athletic background from the football ranks. And, of course, as you're well aware, football and wrestling, two entirely different sports.
And, of course, young Todd is finding out, and it's going to be a rough match for me. Oh, a clothesline. Garvin outsmarted him right there. It's just experience with the expect big things out of Todd Champion, but gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, the winner, as he caught him with that clothesline coming out of the corner there, Precious, along with her man, and the gorgeous one, another victory. We'll get to see that maneuver in slow motion. Here it comes, as Garvin is whipped into the turnbuckle. Todd comes charging in, but Garvin waiting for him. With that big clothesline, a lateral press, the winner, the gorgeous one, Jimmy Garvin.
Fans, we'll be right here, Tony Schiavone. Tony, fans, at the beginning of the program, we mentioned a severe injury to Ricky Morton at the hands of Nature Boy Ric Flair, Tully Blanchard, Big Arn Anderson. Tony, you saw it. We want all of the fans also to see what happened.
Once again, the wrestling world's in an uproar. The hands of Nature Boy Ric Flair, a very severe injury by Ric Flair to Ricky Morton. The match is going on right now, Bob Caudle. Once again, we see that Ricky Morton has Nature Boy Ric Flair down, but as as we have seen so many times, as we saw in a dressing room incident not too long ago in Greensboro, North Carolina. Here come the remainders of the Horsemen, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard. A three-on-one, and Ricky Morton cannot do anything. No man can do anything on a three-on-one.
He's completely helpless against them when all three get in there after him. And now look what they're doing to him here, Tony.
James J. Dillon comes in. They're holding Ricky Morton face down on the mat. Ric Flair is up, and right there, with that big knee on the back of the head, shatters the nose of Ricky Morton. It's unbelievable.
It certainly is, Tony, but you know Nature Boy wasn't through at this point.
He certainly was not through, and we're going to come back in just a second to take a look at what Ric Flair did again to Ricky Morton right there in the ring, same situation. It's not very pleasant to look at, but it's something we feel we have to show this time.
And fans, we'll show you that in just a moment. Whole crew here, Paul.
Bob, it's in black and white. The army is put together, and Jimmy Valiant has exposed his army, the Raging Bull. Now, let me tell you something, Valiant. You get out here and you say that you're going to use those clippers on Chaska, on myself, and the army. Well, you better think again, because we're moving forward, and forward is what we're going to do. Chaska, we're going to get the job done.
Oh, yeah, boss. We're going to get the job done. You know why? Because, Jimmy Valiant, you think we forgot about the fact that you have lost your hair? Well, let me tell you what, Manny Fernandez, you is another sucker. You're going to lose your hair. And I'm going to tell you what, if you think that you're going to make this one right here, the big nasty one that cuts your hair, if you think you're going to make me bald, every man in my army has pledged me with our leader to say that we gonna step on your face and destroy all your dreams. That your fast fans and all the rest of them hillbillies got to do it. The right boss, ain't the right. We gonna get it.
Baron, are you ready for the war?
We are prepared. T.J. Khan, the Barbarian, Jimmy Valiant. It doesn't matter who you hire. Your thugs are no match for the army. Whether it's the Raging Bull or Ronnie Garvin, no matter who you get to stand behind you, that's all they're going to do is stand behind you. It's going to be onslaught after onslaught after onslaught. There's no stopping the army. We're coming, and that's all you need to know.
Tony Schiavone back with me now, and Tony, as the fans saw earlier, they saw what happened to Ricky Morton, and as we say, Ric Flair wasn't finished.
Ric Flair, this man injured Dusty Rhodes in his ankle severely last year, Bob, has hurt Ricky Morton once before, and then again. Now, a broken nose is a very serious injury, can be very, very serious, but Ric Flair was not finished with what he did. We're going to take a look once again at Ric Flair. This is after it happened once before. In slow motion, you see the head hitting hard against the mat, shattering the nose of Ricky Morton. You're talking about a young man in pain. Dusty Rhodes comes in to help matters out, but the injury already inflicted.
Ricky. Already it happened. Ricky, I tell you, the fans saw it, and they saw what happened from beginning to end. What are your thoughts, and what are your comments about that?
Well, Bob, you know, it all started out with a slap on TV, and then Ric Flair left half my face in the Coliseum in Greensboro. Then he come out and try to crush my face. But you see, Ric Flair, my face is a lot. It's a lot further from my heart than you think it is, brother, because my heart stands up for all these nice people out here. And what they want is what I'm going to do. You see, Ric Flair, you have a big nose, brother, and I'm waiting for the day that I can see your nose look just like mine is right here on TV. It's an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. That's the way I was brought up, Ric Flair, and that's the way it's going to end.
And, Robert, you're going to be standing right behind him, right?
You ain't lying. Rock and roll is interstate. You know, there's no saying. You're never too old for rock and roll, and we got payback time to do, Bob.
There it is, Rock and Roll Express. In the ring, here is Jim Cornette.
Ladies and gentlemen, my mother's favorite tag team, Loverboy Dennis and Beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express. We'll be right back.
Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express. Johnny Weaver, I noticed a great big guy.
Boy, that was a big
standing
dude.
In the ring there with Cornette.
That's a big fella that Cornette had with him. Don't know anything about him, but right here, there you see the shot. That's a big individual right there. As the Midnight Express, the World Tag Team Champions, go to work on their opponents during this match. And David Dillinger and Mike Somani. But you know, the Midnight Express, the James boys are lurking right on their trail.
You're set a mouthful there, Johnny, as the James boys are after him, and I think they're going to stay right after him. But we've had another quick win here as the Midnight Express came on real quick to get David Dillinger to the mat and to pin him, Johnny.
And we're going
to
see it again in slow motion. There's the position he wants him in. Beautiful Bobby already on the top turnbuckle. What teamwork by the World Tag Team Champions. This is what makes them the World Tag Team Champions. You're going to see Dennis throw Bobby right on top of David Dillinger, the winner of the World Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express.
And you saw what happened to Ricky Morton, and you saw what Nature Boy Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, and Tully Blanchard do to him, and you saw the results, and you've heard from Ricky Morton. Well, we were able to get the champion, the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair, in the dressing room shortly after that happened. Now, we want you to hear what the world champion had to say about this incident.
You see, what we've got here, whether you and the general public like it or not, is we've got a case of hidden identity. You see, Ricky Morton, as I've said so many times in the past, dared to cross the line into no man's land. You see, no man's land is mine. And anybody that crosses into it, I figure, is trying to take the world title away from me. All my cars, my big houses, all my women. You see, Morton, you've always been insanely jealous of the fact that you were nothing but a punk kid with throngs of little teeny boppers and training bras supporting you and hollering for you. But you see, that never made you the man that you had to be. But once in a while, when you were looking real good, I just had to cut it off. You see, I'm set up to it right here. And tonight, right here, we finally see. You see, when I smashed your face last time, I told you, that was just a warning. Stay away. Now, you're going to carry the scar of what I did to you tonight the rest of your life. Sure, the scars on your face might heal up, but you got a broken nose now, a smashed, disfigured nose. You're ugly, and there's no two ways of looking at it. And I did it. Me, Ric Flair, the world champion, and yes, everybody's out in your mind, I'm proud of it. Because I gave you a warning. I told you, if you play with fire, you are going to get burnt. Don't mess around with Ric Flair unless you're willing to pay the price. Big Dust paid the price with a broken leg. And now you're paying it with a broken nose, punk. Woo!
Wahoo McDaniel, Johnny Weaver.
Of course, the chief of legend, and he's looking for that world TV title held by Arn Anderson. He's also looking for one gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And when the chief looks for you, you're in a lot of trouble.
No doubt about that. And if I was gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, I would be a little bit leery after all of the things that he has said about Wahoo McDaniel. What a quick wrap-up that was with that chop. And Johnny, as we said, nobody hit with a chop like Wahoo.
We're going to see that once more in slow motion. The big chief, Wahoo McDaniel, Randy Mulkey coming off the ropes, and there is that chop. And that puts him away, the winner of the match, Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
Jim Cornette, what in the world, what is this?
Bob Caudle, take a look at a good friend of mine. I knew my mama was sending me a surprise. I didn't exactly know what it was, but it came today, and it's Bubba Rogers. Bubba's an old friend of the Cornette family from Louisville, Kentucky, and he's been a friend for a long time. He's done all kind of things for my mother, and she saw that the James boys were running around. trying to do me bodily harm so the Midnight Express could concentrate on defending their tag team championship, and also so they could concentrate on getting that $50,000 bounty that's on the James Boy's head that she put there. She sent Bubba down to sort of be a close companion of mine, you might say, to be my bodyguard, to make sure that nothing happens to me. Back up, Bob. Carla, get a good look at this man. From now on, anybody that wants to put a hand on me is going to have to go through my friend, Big Bubba Rogers. And I guarantee you this, James, boys, you're the prime candidates for a whooping from this man or the Midnight Express. Bubba's done a lot of favors for my mother in the past. He's done a lot of nasty things, James, boys. So I want you to think about that. When you think about what kind of outlaws you are, think about this man, Bubba Rogers. He's going to be with me from now on. Wherever I am, he's going to be close by. You may not see him. He may be just lurking around. But he's going to be there somewhere, and he's going to assure that no bodily harm comes to me so that the Midnight Express can go about concentrating on doing just like they've been doing, being the greatest tag team that's ever been in professional wrestling, the world champions, and getting the mask off the James boys once and for all. Come on, Bubba, let's go.
Johnny Weaver, his partner, of course, Ricky Martin,
with
a badly broken nose, and you get a good look at him there outside of the ring as Gene Ligon goes right after Robert Gibson, even before the bell.
Reversal by Gibson, the elbow! Down is Ligon!
Boy, that Ricky...
here he goes! Good luck! Robert Gibson on top of it! He's got a victory!
The winner of the match, Robert Gibson. And another great quick win for Robert Gibson. Johnny, just an outstanding young athlete. Watch in slow motion what he does right here to Gene Ligon.
And it's the vertical suplex that puts away Ligon for one half of the Rock and Roll Express, Robert Gibson.
Stay tuned, fans. We'll be right back with more action after these commercial messages about the Mid-Atlantic wrestling events coming to your area.
The best in summertime family fun is coming your way. It's the Great American Bash 1986 coming your way. And you can be part of the Great American Bash 86 on Tuesday, July 1st. The festivities begin at 6:30 at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. There you'll see skydivers, fireworks, a concert with Joe Ely and Delbert McClinton, and the best in professional wrestling. Be a part of the Great American Bash at Veterans Stadium on July 1st at 6:30. At the Great American Bash at Veterans Stadium, the concert will feature Joe Ely and Delbert McClinton. On this great wrestling card, a bunkhouse match. The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez against Shaska with Paul Jones. Indian Stretch, Wahoo McDaniel against Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious. Tape fist match, Ryan Garvin against Tully Blanchard with James J. Dillon. A pole match with Glove on top of the pole as Baron Von Raschke will take on Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vine. Special six-man tag team match. The Rock and Roll Express and Baby Doll is their partner against the Midnight Express, and Jim Cornette will be their partner. You will see Magnum T.A. U.S. Heavyweight Title match against Nikita Koloff. In a steel cage, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Road Warrior Animal will take on Ole and Arn Anderson. And for the NWA World Heavyweight Title match, your boy Ric Flair defends against Road Warrior Hawk. The Great American Bash at Veterans Stadium. Six-man tag team match. The Rock and Roll Express with Baby Doll in their quarter. You'll be in the quarter of the Midnight Express.
All right, Rock and Roll Express. This proves right here that the Midnight Express can beat you. We've done it countless times, but Baby Doll, you're the one I'm after, and I'm going to make one promise, darling. No woman can beat a man in a wrestling match. I'm not only going to embarrass you, I'm going to beat your brains out.
U.S. Heavyweight Title Magnum T.A. against Nikita Koloff.
Yes, we're going to witness a more embarrassment on your part, Magnum T.A. Many times now, nephew Nikita has embarrassed you, put you down. United States Heavyweight Title is at stake, Veterans Stadium, July 1st, the birth date of United States, when it's going to be the death of you, Magnum.
Well,
T.A.
I'm on
Maybe by this time, Nikita got title, and he come for me.
In a steel cage, Ole and Arn Anderson against Road Warrior, Animal of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Tony Giovanni, I don't have my tie tied or my shirt buttoned, simply because of the fact when I get to Philadelphia, Rhodes, it's you and Animal. Divide and conquer. Divide the Road Warriors and you can conquer them. The bottom line is, Rhodes, the Rock is back. I told you, when the Rock gets back, the Four Horsemen are complete. We're coming for you in Veterans Stadium.
We have seen some various things take place that turns a man's stomach to mush. Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, has never taken a back seat to anybody. Now, Jim Cornette, Bubba Rogers, you bring him out and flown him in front of this television set and saying how big and bad he is, and the James boys going to heed the warning, and Dusty Rhodes and Magnum T.A. are going to heed the warning of Bubba Rogers. Big Bubba, you put that man in my face one time, and he will be about 3'2", eyes of blue, black and blue from head to toe, Jack. And the thing that turns my gut, and I got to say it because my man is not out here talking with me and Dahl right now. America's team, Magnum T.A., you Russian swine, gutless, no good, low life human being. This country is America, United States. Magnum T.A., Dusty Rhodes, and every crippled child, every man, every woman that can breathe and crawl across this great land of freedom is living in the promised land, is living on the end of a lightning bolt crashing through this short period of life that we live in. Ivan Koloff and Nikita Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev, this country is no longer big enough for Magnum T.A. and you. It's no longer big enough, and we will.
You'll see great wrestling action each week on Sports Channel. Host Ken Resnick and commentators Larry Nelson and Vern Gagne have all the exciting moments that make up Pro Wrestling USA AWA style. Such stars as Larry Sabisco, Nick Bockwinkle, Stan the Lariat Hansen, Baron Von Raschke, and the tag team of the Long Riders make up a great lineup of hard-hitting action. Pro Wrestling USA, All-Star Wrestling on Sports Channel.
Tag team action, you're looking at Tully Blanchard. Also his partner, Steve Regal, and in there with him, Johnny Weaver, Mr. James J. Dillon.
The head man of Tully Blanchard Enterprises, and of course, Bob Tully Blanchard, the reigning national champion, with Ronnie Garvin breathing right down his neck. However, Tully Blanchard was in on that incident again on Ricky Morton, as once again him, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, tried to disarrange his face.
That's right. Tully Blanchard right in there and had a big part of that. The opponents across the way, Johnny, we try to get him in right here. South and Rocky Kernoodle, and at South in the ring with Kernoodle out and Tully Blanchard in as the match gets underway. You're right, Tully Blanchard seems to be right in there. Whatever Ric Flair and whatever Arn Anderson is involved in, here is Tully Blanchard, a big part of it. No doubt about that. Speaking of the champion, Ric Flair, what about that announcement that Ric Flair, or the champion, is going to defend his title 14 times over a 30-day period? Johnny, no champion has ever done that. Nobody's ever even come close to approaching that feat.
Especially that Ric Flair has got to defend against the top men in the country every time. He's got to put that title on the line against the very top of the NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. And we're going to find out just what Flair really is. And this one, if he can come through there, I don't know about this.
That's right. We're just going to find out just what kind of a man Ric Flair is. That's for certain with this.
Bob, Tully Blanchard, his partner is Steve Regal, a seasoned veteran, a really accomplished wrestler, been around a long time, has had a lot of individual titles. And he's going to be a formidable man here in Mid-Atlantic Wrestling. Of course, he's a great partner for Tully Blanchard. Steve Regal, we're going to hear a lot about him.
Blanchard with Kernoodle on the mat. Kernoodle got to his feet, but he's over near the corner. And it's going to be Blanchard making the tag. Here's Regal.
Bob, if we went back to try to summarize this hour, there's so much happening, it all boils down. That great American bash is going to be something. There's going to be all kind of news, Paige.
And the great American bash is coming, and coming to your town.
Lateral press here by Regal. I thought Regal had a victory here.
Now, Johnny mentioned a lot happening during this hour. We've still got a lot to come. We're going to see the big Russian, Nikita Koloff, in our next match. Johnny, I was stunned at what happened at that press conference, and you saw Magnum T.A. Boy, he was like he had springs as he bounced across the table to get at the Russian.
Rocky Kernoodle in there now, and he's giving the national heavyweight champ all he can handle, but there's Blanchard into the eyes. That stops him and changes the tide of battle.
Nodal was able to get to the corner for the tag, though, and this is Todd. Blanchard high out of the air for that flip.
Blanchard quickly wise enough to tag his fresh partner, Steve Riggle.
And Tully Blanchard in pain as he tries to get out of the ring after that backflip, which was very, very high in the air. But Regal now was south into the corner.
And what about that Bubba Rogers on the scene with Jim Cornette? That's a huge individual. We know that Dusty Rhodes, Magnum T.A., the James boys, breathing right down to the necks of the world tag team champions, the Midnight Express. But that's now a huge individual on the scene.
When you talk about a big one, Johnny, I think he's in the neighborhood of about 6'9 and somewhere around 300 pounds. And boy, that's big in anybody's language.
He looked awesome next to Cornette out there in this program. And Cornette says he's going to stay right by him. A great American bash. Tremendous. Event. You don't want to miss it wherever it's going to be in all the great cities. And a great tribute by the president of the National Wrestling Alliance, Bob Geigel.
Boy, Blanchard for a minute was completely defenseless. He had his arms behind his back, and he had his whole front exposed.
Never sell Tully Blanchard short. He has been a champion, had some kind of belt around his waist for many, many years. Of course, one of the three horsemen and one of the individuals that has really rearranged the face of Ricky Morton on Rock and Roll Express, but rock and roll is here to stay.
A switch by South. Regal was going to whip him to the turnbuckle, and it's Regal he winds up with his back slam hard to the buckle. Johnny, there's where the experience tells, as you saw Regal come out of the corner.
Oh, fine drop kick.
Boy, he got high in the air for that one.
The man is a great athlete. And James J. Dillon in that corner, and he's overseeing the progress in this match as Steve Regal and Tully Blanchard teaming together. There's a great shot, guys. The head man of Tully Blanchard's enterprise, James J. Dillon.
The brains behind it all. And I tell you, James J. Dillon, again, has taken an individual and taken him right and kept him right at the top, Johnny. You may not like what James J. Dillon does, but you got to admire the result.
He's been very successful for many years. Here's Blanchard on me.
Charles went through the ropes and Blanchard right out after him.
Blanchard, he's a top five.
He literally just throws South back to the ring, across the ring to the knee.
Slingshot, maybe? Yes, sir. Slingshot, suplex by Tully Blanchard.
You don't get up from that, man. Tully Blanchard with that patented slingshot move of his. As he has South in and off of the rope, hard down with a suplex, Johnny.
And we're going to get the
south. Gets him high in the air above the ropes and uses the rope like a swing shot. Suplex towards south, the winner of the match. Steve Regal and Tully Blanchard.
Stay tuned, fans. We'll be right back with more action after these commercial messages about the Mid-Atlantic wrestling events coming to your area.
It's the best in summertime family fun coming your way. The Great American Bash 86. And you can be part of the Great American Bash 86 at Veterans Stadium on Tuesday, July 1st at 6:30 in Philadelphia. The best in wrestling. The best in music. A concert with Joe Ely and Delbert McClinton. Skydivers, fireworks, and the best in wrestling. Tuesday, July 1st at 6:30. The Great American Bash at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. At Veterans Stadium, the Great American Bash, the concert will feature Joe Ely and Delbert McClinton. And on this great pro wrestling card, a bunkhouse match, the Raging Bull Manny Fernandez will take on Shoska with Paul Jones. Indian strap match. Chief Wahoo McDaniel gets gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious. Tape this match. Ryan Garvin will take on Tully Blanchard with James J. Dillon. A pole match with the glove on top of the pole as Baron Von Raschke takes on Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vine. Special six-man tag team match. The Rocky Roll Express and Baby Doll against the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette. U.S. Heavyweight title, it's Macw T.A. against Nikita Koloff. In a steel cage, Dusty Rhodes and Road Warrior Animal will take on Ole and Arn Anderson. And for the NWA World Heavyweight title, it's your boy Ric Flair defends against Road Warrior Hawk. It's the Great American Bash at Veterans Stadium. Let's bring in Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vine against Baron Von Raschke. A pole match. The glove is on top of the pole.
First of all, I want to say all my people, all my brothers and sisters, right there, Philadelphia, PA, your booking man's coming. Tony, I can't turn around unless I get knocked silly by this black glove. Well, that's final. We got it. We got the pole match. The glove's going to be on top of a 10-foot pole. And Baron Von Raschke, the booking man's coming down with the glove on. And I want to do some damage. Pumping it.
U.S. heavyweight title match, Macw T.A. against Nikita Koloff.
Well, I can think of absolutely no better way to kick off the bash in Veterans Stadium than to finally have this confrontation with myself and Nikita Koloff. Tired of all the talking. Tired of all the paperwork. I want to get it done. Now, you've insulted my pride, my dignity, everything I hold dear. Well, this is on the line in the Great American Bash. July the 1st, Nikita Koloff. It's going to be a great day for America. A real bad day for Russia. You think you got some kind of psychological head game going on with me? All you've done is lit the fuse, and this is a fuse you can't put out. All you can do is walk in that ring and let me have my way. This title is staying right here.
It's the t-shirt buy of the century for you wrestling fans. Get in on this fantastic opportunity while supplies last. All your favorite wrestling stars are now available. He may be an opponent's nightmare, but he's the American dream. That's Dusty Rhodes. And America's heartthrob is pure dynamite when he explodes into action. None other than Macw T.A. Put them together and you have an all-American combination when Dusty and Macw step into the ring as America's team. The beat goes on to the tune of wrestling's most exciting young team, the Rock and Roll Express. Love him or hate him, he does it with style. Now you can do it with Flair. It's the nature boy himself, Ric Flair. She's Dusty darling and everybody's sweetheart. That's Baby Doll, of course. So get them while supplies last. Don't put it off. Be the first to own the entire collection. Send $12 for each t-shirt, plus $3 for handling the postage. The Jim Crockett Promotions, 421 Briarman Drive, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28209. Only money orders will be accepted and supplies are limited.
Crusher Khrushchev, Ivan Koloff. Ivan, we've seen the press conference now. What are your comments about what happened there?
Did you see how this Macw T.A. conducted himself at press conference? What a low-class, ungrateful man he is. First of all, he insulted Macw Nikita, make him very angry by bringing a woman, his mother, to press conference. Then after Macw Nikita bend over backwards to meet the terms of the contract, he jumps on Nikita and tries to beat him up. What was wrong, Macw T.A.? Did you have second thoughts about signing contract and you tried to get jump on Nikita? But you see, you got hurt and on June the 7th. And that Vander, I tell you, you're going to get hurt again. Not only physically, but your pride. Because W. Nikita is going to take United States title away from you. And you can see Crusher Khrushchev has got rid of the crutches. But he has not got rid of the anger. No,
I see the big change come over Crusher in the last couple of months. I tell him, it don't do no good, Crusher Khrushchev, to go and break your furniture up in your apartment, to put the fist through the wall. But I know how Crusher feels. I know the anger inside. Because of his broken leg, we lose 6 World 1918 Cup. But Dustin Rhodes and Road Warriors, the American Bash, 14 different events, we're going to get trophy back.
All right, and we're talking about into the ring, the big Nikita, and there he is, fans. Johnny, what about the look at the expression on the face of the Russian.
Well, we know Nikita for a long while now, what a giant of a man he is. Of course, a threat for any title, and you know, he's got to be a lot of anger in Nikita, not only about Magnum TA, but also that they just lost that World 6 Man Tag Team trophy to the Road Warriors and Dusty Rhodes.
Fans, you saw what happened. You saw the press conference. You saw what took place as Magnum TA went charging after Big Nikita Koloff. Boy, I tell you, Johnny, that match is really going to be something when those two come together.
Well, it certainly is. And again, Magnum is a great champion. I think he just fell a little bit into the psychological warfare of the Russians. Of course, everybody can feel how Magnum does feel right there because he was talking about his mother. Everybody adores their mother. And of course, that was a really dirty low blow at Dusty Rhodes, who alluded to earlier in the program.
Look at Tully's eight as he goes to work on Nikita. First, he grabbed him by the foot, landed some good blows, but the Russian was to take a powerful man coming right back off of the rope.
A giant of a man. Nikita Koloff, 280 pounds, and a real threat to any title.
And it's 280 pounds of all muscle and steel muscle at that.
And conditioning, the best. You know the Russians are going to be in great condition. Russia Khrushchev looking well out there on the outside of the ring, has gotten rid of those crutches, and you know he still hasn't gotten rid of the pain, or who put it there. That was the Road Warrior.
Well, and that's one thing that Ivan Koloff mentioned, that Crusher has still got that very vividly in his mind, and it's going to stay right there. Zane now from outside of the ring. Oh, but he missed him. It was a good quick move on the part of Nikita Koloff.
He is sharp. He is ready. Of course, Ivan, the Russian bear, he has them primed all the time. And Nikita really looks ready. Playing a mind game with Magnum on that psychological maneuver there at the press conference. Gives him some of an edge there. And that's what they were looking for, Bobby.
He was trying to get to Magnum. He certainly succeeded because he really touched the nerve with Magnum on that one, Johnny. Zane on his knees now, trying to fight back. Landing those rights, but Big Nikita's just holding his ground.
Well, here's where conditioning comes in. Nikita's taking all the sting out of Tony's day. The punches are very limited in the damage that they're doing. Nikita is just shrugging him off, and I would say he's great. Oh, here he's outside. Look at him outside of the ring now. Oh, Tony's day on that rail.
Under that metal rail. He slammed him hard down on it and over the rail. Zane is into the crowd at ringside.
What a muscular, huge individual. Nikita Koloff.
On his hands and knees, crawling back toward the ring, Tony Zane.
Nikita stands tall, just waiting for him. He knows he's overpowering Zane Wright at this particular moment.
All of his weight down on that neck over the rope, and Zane is on the apron again. Right over the ape with that big victory yell.
There he is, Johnny. Question right now, does he have Magnum where he wants him? Or is he selling Magnum too short? Don't sell Magnum TA short. Too big of a United States champion, and I know he'll give it everything he's got against Nikita Koloff. Nikita is going to find out he's going to be a rough match.
He's got a pin, Zane. He caught him in a Russian tickle. When he went down for that, all he had to do was roll him over and cover. Look at the muscles on the man.
Unbelievable physical specimen right there, Nikita Koloff. We're going to see the way he won that match again. In slow motion, Nikita Koloff with Zane coming off the rope. He's got that big Russian sickle, and it doesn't miss as Tony Zane goes down, and the winner of the match, Nikita Koloff.
Jim Cornette and Bubba, Jim.
Here's Bubba. Let me tell you something. I'm sure by now everybody, including you, Bob Caudle, knows my brand new bodyguard, Bubba Rogers, old friend of my mother's from back home. You know, he's been a lot of help to Mom over the years. Every time maybe somebody was negligent in paying a little debt, well, Bubba was nice enough to go out there and collect that debt for very little recompense. Every time if somebody was negligent in delivering something that my mama needed or maybe doing something that my mama needed done, well, Bubba went right over there, and Bubba was nice enough to take care of that. And now when she heard all the trouble I was having with the James boys, being cowards, jumping out of the cover of darkness, coming out from under some rock and trying to do me bodily harm, she knows Loverboy did us a beautiful Bobby can take care of them, but they got to concentrate on being the greatest team in wrestling. They got to concentrate on defending the World Tag Team Championship. So she asked Bubba, and Bubba was nice enough to comply with her wishes, just like he always does, to come on down here, to stick with me just like glue, and to make sure that those two dirty back jumpers can't do me any physical harm while the Midnight Express is in that ring. And James Boyce, there is a $50,000 bounty out on you. When those hoods come off, and believe me, they're going to, and you're revealed to be Dusty Rhodes of Magnum TA, then you're going to be out of professional wrestling where you never should have been in the first place, and I'm going to be a happy man. And until then, Bubba Rogers is going to make sure that you or nobody else in the world, I don't care who it is, lays one finger on me or does me any harm in any way. And then, like I said, I'm going to be a happy man, Bob Caudle, and I'm going to give Big Bubba a real nice reward.
Fans, don't forget the Great American Bash coming soon. Don't miss it. We'll see you next week. Until then, so long for now.